So, I'm gonna go out for a little bit, okay, Makoto? Come on, that isn't what you say when you're seeing someone off, is it?
Don't worry, Yuichi. I'll play with Makoto while you're gone.
I'm sorry about this. I know you're busy.
I'm the one who offered to watch after her. It's no problem. Isn't that right, Makoto? You and I are gonna have a good time until Yuichi comes back.
She's lost the power of speech entirely. And she hardly ever laughs or gets angry anymore. I think that she's right on the verge of losing her human emotions. And Akiko and Nayuki, they both take care of her like she was family. But I get the feeling that she only really lets her guard down around me. Could you please, do you think that you could meet her? I know that it would be hard. But I think that maybe you could understand her better than anyone else, and maybe you could help us reach out to her.
It's nice to meet you. My name is Michio Amano. What is your name? What's your name? You do have a name, don't you? Come here.
Go on. I'll be right here. It's all right.
Let's see if we can't do something to calm her down.
You're right.
Okay, can you tell me your name? Can you try to remember it for me?
Ma?
Ma? Now what comes after that?
Makoto.
Makoto? Well, that's a pretty name.
Makoto?
Okay, now can you tell me what his name is? I'm sure you've said his name lots of times before. Come on, you can do it.
Yuichi! Yuichi! you, Ricky!
Yes. Makoto, you did it. You remembered my name. Good job. I'm so proud of you. Thanks, Amino.
This is probably temporary. I wouldn't be surprised if she forgets again by the time you get home.
Right, but that was enough. Thank you.
Remember what I said before. The next time she runs a fever and falls asleep, she most likely won't wake up. If she had any final wishes, anything that she wanted, this would be your last chance to take care of it.
I'm trying to think if she had any final wishes. She should have asked for a way better present than that. Can I ask you something? Is there anything you wanted to do but you haven't had the chance? Wasn't there anything? I'll bet there was a bunch of stuff. I'll do whatever you want, okay?
This is a nice change of pace, isn't it?
Yes. It's been a long time since we ate at a restaurant.
Thank you so much for taking us out. Makoto, you can order anything you want.
Oh, that was so delicious.
I had a lot of fun, too. Did you, Makoto?
Oh.
Hey, I've got an idea. How about we all go take advantage of that?
You mean the photo booth? That's the kind where you take pictures and it makes stickers out of them.
Sounds good to me. Get your smiles ready.
Yeah, let's go. Come on, Makoto.
There's not much room. Can all four of us fit in here?
Watch out, Mom. Don't push me.
This looks kind of complicated.
It can't be that bad. I mean, grade school kids do this all the time.
Makoto, what are you doing standing all the way over there? You don't have to watch from a distance today. We want you to come be in the picture with us.
Makoto, please come take a family picture with us, would you?
What's the matter? Hurry up so you can get your stickers.
Come on, it's okay, Makoto.
Makoto?
Makoto. Okay, Makoto will be in the middle.
Oh, look, you can add little messages to the picture.
Really? Just leave that to me.
Can you really write with that thing?
Yeah.
Okay, that should do it.
Let's take the picture.
Okay.
Are you ready, Makoto?
Oh.
Then here we go. 3, 2, 1, smile!
That night, Makoto developed a fever. Makoto? You're awake!
Oh.
Are you okay? Are you feeling any better this morning? Way to hang in there, Makoto.
Oh.
Is there anything you want me to go get for you? Like maybe a pork bun or something? Anything?
Oh.
That's right. All you ever really wanted all this time was to be with me. That was the only thing that mattered to you.
Oh.
I've got an idea. How about I read you a story? Your favorite book, Makoto? Don't fall asleep, okay? At least not until I finish reading this to you. All right, now how does this thing start again? Love always strikes when you least expect it. Definitely come back to get you. And when I finally return, let us join together as one. Let's get married.
I wanna get married.
You still want to marry me, Makoto?
Oh.
Oh my, Makoto was able to get out of bed?
Yes, and we figured the two of us would go out for a little bit.
Going out and playing hooky? You're quite the delinquent.
Yeah, I guess it looks that way.
I'm kidding. I'll have a delicious dinner ready for the two of you when you get back, okay?
Well, we should probably get going. Don't you think so, Makoto?
Oh. I'll see you soon.
You're skipping school too? We're pretty bad role models, huh?
If I can't do anything else to help, at least I can be here. And besides, I consider you a friend.
I was thinking we'd stop by the school and then go up the hill again.
That makes sense. And I think it's a good idea. After all, that hill is where she was born. Okay, I'm gonna say goodbye now.
All right. Don't forget to deliver that message.
Sure. It goes to Nayuki Minase, right? Makoto, I hope we can play again sometime soon.
Aww.
Well, see you later.
Makoto! Are you all right?
Yeah, she's fine. She just wanted to play with you is all.
I see. Well, I'm on my lunch break, so I don't have a lot of time, but what do you want to do, Makoto? Makoto, as soon as I get home, we'll play. Does that sound all right? And we can talk. I feel like there are so many things I wanted to tell you, but I've never had the time before now.
Nayuki!
What is it?
Thank you so much.
No thanks are necessary. See you later!
Why don't you have a seat, Makoto? Here, it's a pork bun. I got a lot, so eat as many as you want. We should probably get started. Hey, Makoto, you didn't fall asleep, did you?
No.
Come on, it isn't bedtime yet. What do you say we get started? I couldn't afford a whole wedding outfit, but I figured this was the most important part. We'll have to make do. Let's see how it looks. Don't worry, just keep your hand on it. We don't want it to blow away. Here we go. I, Yuichi Ayazawa, solemnly promise to stay by Makoto Sawatari's side forever, in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, forever from this day forward. How does that sound? Was that what you wanted? Huh, Makoto? And with that, I believe I was able to make Makoto's wish come true. She was always so playful and made trouble for everyone. But was Makoto really happy? Staying with someone like me, who she said she hated, was Makoto really happy? Was everything she went through worth it? Makoto, everyone always loved you, you know? We were constantly fighting, but I think I loved you more than anyone else. And if you had realized that then you must have been happy. But you were such a pill sometimes, you know? So I'm a little worried that you didn't realize. Makoto, I don't ever want to let you go. Oh, come on. Don't cry, Makoto. Don't worry about that silly old veil. We're supposed to be celebrating. Because today we became a real family, Makoto. So come on, please don't cry anymore, okay? Please, Makoto? You really can be impossible, you know that? Okay, come over here and I'll pat your head for you. Why don't we play with your bracelet a little bit, okay, Makoto? We can make it go jingle, jingle. Come on, you can do it. Move your wrist back and forth. Don't you remember how much you used to love playing with your bracelet? That's it. Good job. That's pretty fun, huh? Right, Makoto? Makoto, it's your turn to ring them. Go ahead. Go ahead. Come on, you can't fall asleep on me up here. Hey. Good job. Now go on, play with the bells again. You really like that, don't you, Makoto? That's my girl. And now it's my turn to play with it. I hope we can play like this forever, Makoto. Hey, it's your turn. Okay, now, why don't you shake your bracelet for me? Are you listening to me? I thought you liked to make it go jingle jingle. Why don't you want to play anymore? Come on, it's your turn now. Makoto. Makoto, what are you doing standing all the way over there?
Makoto, please come take a family picture with us, would you? What's the matter? Hurry up so you can get your stickers.
Okay, Makoto will be in the middle.
Let's take the picture. Are you ready, Makoto? Then here we go. 3, 2, 1, smile! I wish it was spring. I wish spring would come, then stay forever. I'm relieved to see that you're looking so well today.
Well, that might be the only redeeming quality I have.
Things are better than they seem. When the spring finally comes again, you know what will happen? There'll be baby foxes all over that hill. When one life ends, another begins. New creatures will be born, completing the circle of life. And once again, there will be another soul who longs for nothing more than a little human warmth.
I guess it's possible.
More than just possible, I think it's inevitable. After all, that's part of the mystery of Monomi Hill.
Maybe you've got a point there.
I wouldn't be surprised
If more of the people living in this town were foxes, but they're taking on a human form so nobody realizes it. Anybody who lives in this town could be one. Only nobody knows about it. Even I could be one. Or you could too.
Amado, are you?
I'm just kidding around.
Man, what the heck's wrong with you? Don't scare me like that again.
You have to admit it's something to think about if all of the foxes on that hill possess mysterious powers. Maybe if they got together and focused their powers somehow, nothing short of an incredible miracle would occur. Don't you think that would be exciting?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
It's just a dream, you know? Something that's nice to think about but won't ever happen. Like, wouldn't it be nice if candy fell from the sky?
I don't think I follow. I mean, if there was candy all over the street, I wouldn't really want to eat it.
Come on, Aizawa, you're thinking about it too literally.
And what are you doing? Seems to me that if you're gonna daydream, at least have it make sense. You and me, we were a part of the same daydream for a while. But now we've come back here to the real world.
Say, if you could make a miracle happen, anything in the world, no matter how crazy it sounds, what would it be?
I thought that was obvious.
Did it again, huh?
You're such a liar.
I'm sorry, but I'm totally lost.
Well, I had no idea that you were so popular around this place, Mai.
And another reason I'm happy is because I have a feeling that Ayu and I are gonna become really good friends.
I don't bother telling anyone because no one would believe it.